To know more such amazing stories from Indian history, click the bell icon and subscribe to Live History India.
This is the port town where one of India's newest all-purpose container seaports is being built. But over 1,000 years ago, this area was already a famous port, attracting merchants from all over the world. Vizhinjam, around 20 kilometers from Kerala's capital Thiruvananthapuram, has quite a story to tell. This rock-cut temple, located on the Vizhinjam Beach Road, is our starting point as we trace the story. Believed to be built in the 8th century CE, this temple is all that remains of a time when this port city was the capital of the Ai rulers who held sway over the region. The Ai rulers started off as tribal lords who controlled the hilly regions along the borders of present-day Kerala and Tamil Nadu in the 7th century. They were driven to the Kerala coast by the Pandyas and they established their base in what is now Vizhinjam. This rock-cut temple built by them is dedicated to Lord Shiva and Parvathi. There is also evidence to suggest that it was here in Vizhinjam that the famous Institute of Learning, the Kanthalloor Sala, which is considered as the Nalanda of the South, was located. Literary records show that this was a great center of learning astronomy, arts, philosophy, and even warfare. Due to the repeated attacks by the Cholas and Pandyas, the Sala was destroyed and the educational center was relocated near the famous Sri Padmanabhaswamy Temple, located in the city of Thiruvananthapuram. This later went on to become the hub of Malayalam literature during the 20th century. Vizhinjam has ancient roots that go back to the Greco-Roman times. In fact, many historians believe that this was the port city referred to as Balita in the famous book Periplus of the Eritrean Sea, written in the 1st century CE. The book mentions that Balita was located near Komari, present-day Kanyakumari. Vizhinjam is said to have been at its height between 7th to the 12th centuries. In the 11th century, it was taken over by the Cholas, giving them an important port in the west coast. By this time, Vizhinjam also started accommodating a sizable community of Muslims and Christians who continue to reside here. The famous Muhyiddin Juma Masjid and the statue of Jesus Christ with his arms wide open at the St. Joseph's Shrine shows how the communities continue to thrive here. However, a major setback for the port came when the waterways that connected the Western Ghats and Vizhinjam dried up due to the receding of the surface water levels and the neighbouring ports of Kollam and Kolachal gained prominence. Today, this once proud port city seems to be getting ready to come back into its own.